Alright. I'll make sure no one's around, which I'm sure is a perception check.
Yep.
Don't
You don't
care,
notice anybody.
apparently.
You don't notice anybody.
And we'll attempt to open the storm cellar and enter the house.
And thievery check. It is locked.
Oh, I get tools with that.
Yep.
21.
You open it easily. And I'm going to make sure. Do you just go through? Because
I go through and close the door behind me.
I'm assuming you're doing it stealthily too, so you don't make a
Well,
ruckus
yeah.
making the noise. Okay, I'm not gonna make you roll for it. I'm assuming you know how to close the door. silently, at least. All right, the cellar is rather dark, which is not a problem for you. It is basically just a storage cellar for there's some wine down there, tank wine barrels or not wine wine barrels, beer barrels, and random boxes and fixings for whatever. If you want to give me a perception check really quick.
Oh, I was about to say, looking through the wine, did I see any like high quality shit?
You do find some that might seem high quality to you. I would say three.
I'll grab the three and put them to the next to the door to
Okay. Storm
the
cellar.
door cellar. Yeah,
Yep.
put it
At
next to there and just continue along the way.
to the back of the room, you see a stairway going up.
Go up the stairway to a door, I'm guessing.
Correct.
Locked?
No.
Ooh, alright. Open it quietly, kind of stick my head around, make sure I'm not in view of anything.
Nope. All the candles are snuffed. It doesn't look like anybody is in this in this in the house. If you're staying quiet, you know, listening for anybody, you don't hear anybody either.
Okay.
You're just like, I
Then
hope he's not married. I hope he's not married.
yeah, I'm sure she would be easy to kill. Anyways,
You go into the main hallway base. All right, you're going inside.
yeah, go inside, and if I get near any windows, essentially just pull the blinds so they haven't been already, so no one can see in.
Okay, you do that. There are a couple if you're looking for things to possibly lift.
Yep, shiny things.
You do find some shiny things just on the first floor. A couple of golden of what look to be golden plates, a few candle holders, some silken table mats. High quality silk table mats. And the rest you really can't take out. There's a grandfather clock, a piano.
Small things.
Yes. Some dishware, or you take some silverware. If you would like. Some silvers.
All right. There's a second story to the house.
Yes, there is.
Essentially, put the stuff that I grabbed by the door
Back
to
downstairs.
the. Yeah, downstairs.
Okay.
And sneak my way up to the second story.
All right, the steps creak as you go up, but nothing outside of that. Upstairs is a hallway with two doors or three doors, one to your left, one to your right, and one in front of you.
Start with the one on the right.
One on the right. You open it up. Well, it's unlocked. You open it up. I'm guessing sneakily, quiet look around before fully opening the door. Okay, rinse and repeat on all the doors.
Pretty much.
Okay. You see, this is a study. A desk with one window and a few bookshelves.
Right.
And one candle holder. If you're looking for anything of value here, give me a perception check on some things.
Yeah.
No. To you, it's just a bunch of paperwork.
Nothing in any of the drawers or.
Just inkwells, some feathers, spare note paper type things like that.
Right. Go back, close the door. Go across the hallway. So the one that would be on the left.
The one on the left, you open that one. That's his bedroom.
Okay.
And in that one, large rug, huge bed, silken covers, and you find there's a nightstand next to the bed along with two dressers. Assuming you're going through those items, you are finding a lot of silken clothing. And one dresser is just full of just garbage clothing. Just stuff that looks like like his normal wear that he would wear, and other things were his formal wear.
The stuff that he's pissed in.
Yes. And inside his nightstand, you find a... let's see, what is it? Another sack of gold. Another little baggie of gold. And a few other miscellaneous pieces of jewelry.
Alright. Oh. I'm actually going to take... I'm sure the pillows have, like, covers on them, right?
Correct.
I'm going to just take a cover pillow and start, like, pretty much putting what I got in there.
Okay.
And we'll head into the other room if there's nothing else in there.
All right. This room
I'll
is...
Check, I'll check under the mattress and under the bed, too.
Nothing there.
All right.
You go off to the last room?
Yep.
It is locked.
Oh. Always good things in locked doors. 20 to unlock.
You make it.
Slowly open, look around.
It is a large, empty room with a telescope pointing out a window. With one chair.
Where is this telescope pointing to?
Are you going up to it and looking?
Pretty much.
Okay. You look through the telescope and it points into another person's bedroom across the hall.
Oh, this guy's a creep. And I'll actually take the telescope.
You're an evil man. Or woman.
Yes.
And the floor is lit, littered with tissue paper.
I gingerly step around.
Okay. I'm going to need a ginger check.
I suppose the closest thing. I got stealth. There. I avoid it like the plague.
All right, you easily take all this shit. Basically, you're going your way back out the same way you came in.
Mm-hmm.
All right. You open up the cellar door and close it behind you. And now the hard part is, how are you going to get from where you are back to home?
Actually, how far am I away from my fence right now?
About 200 yards from where the opening is to get to where you're at. And there's no way you can get to it without going through the main street. You have to cross the street. Unless you go in through the back way, which is going through the under city, which will require streetwise. And maybe Dungeoneering, just because I want to use Dungeoneering as an actual skill. So,
how much time do I have left before, I would think?
Minutes.
God damn it. Do I know a back way to my house?
Yes, but you're still going to have to cross the street to get to it.
Cross the street. Evidence. Pillowcase.
You look very shady at this moment, by the way.
It looks odd, yeah. How would I do
You're
this?
A drow Santa now. And a monk comes walking up behind you again. How are you doing? No.
You see my master yet?
I'm going to essentially try and find like the go through the back ways, try and find like the smallest crossing I can get for the main road. Try and get as far away from like the biggest crowd I can.
Okay, you're gonna be taking a longer route.
Yeah, I know.
So, I'm gonna have to make a check or make a roll. Sure. Give me two stealth checks, and that'll be it. Or two stealth checks and one acrobatic check.
Acrobatics fucked.
You're good. Now, how do I make a GM roll?
Slash RSEC.
R what?
RSEC. Basically, roll secretly.
Okay.
A space, and don't put brackets around the D whatever.
You can also do bracket GM colon D whatever, and that works too.
All right, you make it home. I'm assuming you're going to the front door. Or are you going into the back? There's a back door. That's not facing any of the streets or anything like that, which I would assume you'd be using.
Yeah.
Okay.
Back door.
You make it into the back door, and you hear from the living room. Is that you?
Yes, it's me. I have more stuff.
You're 3 minutes late.
Oh, fuck.
I rolled a 2 on the save.
Yes, I am sorry, but this fat man had a lot of stuff in his house.
Throw it on the table.
And she does as such. And I also picked a lot of pockets, so I'll throw it on the table too.
Are you going to keep your 25 gold that you got from the other men? From your
Yeah, I'll keep the 25 gold. I'll try and keep it hidden like my pants or on the inside of my pants or something.
Okay. I'm going to say you've done this before, so you make it. He goes over the stuff and says, you know, he looks at it and just goes, "This will do. Get back up into your room."
Yes, sir. And
you gonna get lippy with me now?
I said yes, sir. I was trying. Yes. Bye. And she walks off to her room.
Fade. Dan.
Yes. That was a good nap I had.
Really?
No.
Go fuck yourself. You hear a small knock at your door.
Yeah.
You've had about, let's say, elapsed time, I would say 3 to 4 hours of sleep.
So, still a little groggy.
Yep. Do you answer the door?
I'll get up and throw something on, I suppose, and I answer the door.
Well,
yes.
What I forgot to mention is they do give you clothes.
Good.
That fits. Hopefully.
Even better.
Let me secret roll that just in case. No.
you roll and they're women's clothes.
Give me clothes for a halfling, damn.
It's the man in the golden armor again. He looks at you up and down. He goes, "You look to be recovering well."
Yeah, I feel a little more alive.
Oh, it's better than what you would have been if you would have stayed. You'd been a corpse on the floor. The queen would
Yes, along with all my friends and family, everyone I've ever known and loved.
Well, you'll have time to avenge them, trust me. The queen would like to see you.
I have nothing else. I must avenge them now.
He puts his arm around your shoulder and starts guiding you out of the room, back to the room that you were in, where the queen is waiting for you at the table again. She stands, gives a slight bow, which is, you know, a little bit... it feels a little unnatural to you, just because, you know, you're not used to somebody of that stature kind of, you know, showing you that kind of respect.
I'll give her a deeper bow back.
Okay. She gestures you to sit down and says, "We're going to put together a small expedition party for the north again. And I want you to be a part of it."
Of course, I must return.
But there are...
Now that I have delivered my message.
I don't want the city to be a part of it just yet. I don't want this... this has to stay inside of this palace. We can't let this out into the open just yet. It'll be mass panic. And I don't think our city will fare well in that kind of a event. I hope you understand.
As you say, you know your city much better than I do, of course.
So I hope you understand we can't actually send our guards with you. We have to send others. So I have I have a contact in the Undercity. I'm sure you've heard of the Undercity where you're from too.
We have a similar sort of part of the city, yes.
There's a lady by the name of Alexis I need you to find. She has ties to the Undercity and could hopefully find some people to help out with this expedition. And also this man. Gives you a piece of paper it's a piece of paper with the names Alexis Whisper, and the other name on it is Thoril. And Thoril, you should be easily be able to find him in the slums. It's not one of our finest areas of the city, but this man has a talent for finding people with gifts.
Very well. I should talk to these people about hiring some mercenaries or adventurers.
Yeah,
to
anybody who's willing to search this. When it comes to Thoril, don't give out too much information. But when it comes to Alexis, feel free to give her any and all information you have. The Undercity is just as tight-lipped as we are, as she, means the palace itself.
Well, yes, anyone who goes with me to the north must be prepared to face what is there.
Now, as far as the mission goes, the expedition, I just want you to go there. I don't need you to go into the city. I just want a status on survivors or anything like that. My airship cannot do these kind of things. I need a ground expedition. The only thing I will find out from the airship is that the city still stands, or if it has completely fallen into enemy hands.
When last I saw it, it was well on its way to being reduced to rubble.
I fear that myself, too.
Yes. All right, I thank you for your help, and wish you luck in preparing your army and your city.
Don't worry.
I fear you will be next.
Don't worry. Like I said, these walls have never been breached before, and I do not see, the Dalhai coming against these walls and winning.
Our walls were not so high or nor so thick, but they availed us not.
She, give me an insight check, please.
Okay. I will use my background to reroll that.
Okay.
I must take the second result. Barely better.
Well, it's going to be better enough for this, even though she's, the queen and shit. You notice that there is something else about these walls that make them, stronger than what you're thinking. That's why she seems so,
Even the magical wards we placed upon the academy, our highest school
shield
of magic, were not powerful enough to repel the monstrous artillery they brought against us.
Well, hopefully, our walls will fare better than your school.
My greatest wish is that it does not come to that, but hopefully.
And she stands up and gestures over to the... God damn it, got something in my throat. Gestures over to the man in gold, and you look behind you, and he's got a... What kind of armor do you wear?
Hide armor.
Okay, he's got an entire set of, basically your replacement hide armor for you, and a your weapon that you usually use. This is the gear.
Shield?
Yeah, this is the gear that you wear, that you got,
okay,
that you have on your sheet. So,
good stuff.
She's like, I hope these are significant. These are enough for you.
Thank you once again. Yes, my gear did not survive the journey very well.
Oh no, that's not nearly enough to protect you. And when you pick up the gear, underneath it is another pouch of gold. Roughly 100 pieces on or 100 pieces on inside of it.
Okay.
And she walks you to the end of the end of that dining, that basically dining slash throne room type room, to the door, and the man in gold escorts you all the way out. If there's any other conversation you'd like to have.
No, not at the moment.
And, okay, as he gets to the front of the door, he basically, the man in gold, says, "These are troubled times coming. Hopefully we are strong enough to withstand them."
I thought the same of my city. I wish you luck with yours, and I will do everything I can to see that no other city suffers the fate of mine.
He nods, clasps his fist to his chest, and gives you, basically bids you a fair journey and looking for who you're looking for.
All right.
Now, you have your option.
All I need to do is hire some adventurers, fight an unstoppable army, and avenge all of my fallen friends. Excellent.
You're just an expedition team right
now.
We're
just getting, yes.
You have an option now. You have your split road. Do you go for Alexis, or do you go for Thoril first?
Which one is... whose name is first in the piece of paper?
Alexis.
We'll go for her then.
Okay, you're not part of the city. I'm assuming she gave you... I'm going to say she gave you a map to find where she would normally be, which would be the inn that she... Okay. Or the inn slash bar. Am I right, Chris?
Yes, the Safe Travels Inn.
Yeah, the Safe Travels Inn. So you basically have directions pointing you right to it.
I will go there then.
Okay. Chris, you're still in the Undercity, right?
Well, I imagine when she dropped off her message, she had to get back to the Safe Travels Inn because she said she's performing tonight.
Correct.
So she'll actually probably be back at the inn performing.
Okay. It's about, let's say, it's dusk. Is it dusk? Sun's going down. Probably about 8 p.m.
Okay, so she might even be just about finishing then.
I think it's...
She's calling in an early night because, remember, she has dinner plans.
Oh, yes. Yes. Okay. So you're probably wrapping up your set. It takes you about 5 minutes to get there, or 10 minutes to get there, Dan.
Okay.
You walk. When you see it, it's a rather nice looking inn. All made out of wood, some little accents of stone. Looks very pretty.
It's snazzy.
Cozy.
Yeah. Very warm. It's a very inviting type of feeling. It's not like the most. It's not like most inns people go to, or most bars where they're, you know, it's loud and obnoxious. It's a lot of calm, quiet talking, enjoying the, a lot of people enjoying the show that's going on. The stripogram.
The burlesque show. well, let's see. There's a bar. I'll sit down at the bar and.
Okay. You do notice her because she did describe. I didn't do this again. She didn't describe her, but you do notice her. She mentioned the tattoo that she has on her leg that shows.
Oh, she's is she performing, or is she just sitting there?
She's you're performing, correct?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, I'm gonna sit at the bar and order a drink while I wait for her to finish.
Big burly dwarf looks up at you from the from his little stool. That he's sitting on, and just basically says, "What do you have?
You have any Stormguard ale?"
I just might, and he kind of scampers off to the back of the bar, or behind the bar, and comes out with a huge fucking pitcher of it. He goes, "I don't think I have the mugs they usually serve this in, but I think this will be big enough."
Looks just about the right size to me.
It's about 2.5 sizes too small. But no, okay.
A pitcher?
It's
a pitcher?
It's
really?
No, it's they. It's think of Vikings. They're huge.
That's like a tankard.
Yeah. They're fucking storm warriors up there. That's kind of what they are. They really like their fucking ale.
Well, I'm normal size, so that's good enough for me.
Okay. You're going to be drunk off your ass for this conversation? No. The demons came from hell.
They killed everyone.
Well, okay.
Ever, no.
Are you going to slowly drink it, or are you going to...
Yeah, I'm just
going
to sip it. I'm not going to get drunk before the conversation.
Okay. I would say probably about... How long do you think, Chris, you'd still be performing?
It's about 8. I don't think she'll be going much. She's probably on her last song then.
Okay, so about 3 minutes go by, and, you know, she comes off stage. And, Chris, go ahead.
She'll head up to the bartender, probably to say her goodbyes. I don't know what's the bartender's name.
I don't have one.
Give him a name. He's my boss. I need a name.
Smiggles. No. I gotta write it down now. Let's see. Tarek.
Tarek.
Tarek. T-E-R-I-C-K. Tarek.
Tarek, I apologize for the short performance tonight, but I'll make sure to make it up for you tomorrow, okay?
Not a problem, kid. And he throws you pretty much your wage for that, for this thing, and it's a little bit heavier than normal.
She's going to give him a kiss on the cheek and then say, thank you very much. Oh, by the way, that Chateau Valadil is fantastic. If you can order some of that again, that'd be great.
Oh, trust me, I already got it. I already got it on order.
I'll catch you tomorrow, then.
Miss Whisper.
Yes.
Pardon the intrusion. Some acquaintances of mine at the palace suggested that I speak to you about hiring some adventurers for a rather urgent matter.
Palace? Well, that must be a very urgent matter indeed.
We have no idea.
I did have dinner plans, but I suppose I could put them off for a moment. Tarek, can I use the room?
Yes.
Right this way.
It's always open for you.
Yeah. she's going to lead Geddon over to this room. It's a relatively small-sized room, but enough for two people to sit comfortably. Mm-hmm. And she's going to shut the door.
And get on her knees.
Well, coincidentally, she is going to get down. She's going to actually get into her bag and start drawing some runic symbols on the door. And she's going to say, this takes just a few moments. I have to focus and keep loose ears from listening onto these sensitive matters. I need concentration to do it, but you can always kill the time by telling me a little bit about yourself.
You are a whore.
Yes, pardon me for not introducing myself. My name is Geddon Shikai, the Storm Guard, City Guard. I suppose late of the City Guard now, as the city is not there anymore.
You're supposed to just tell me about yourself right now. Just not minor things. The sensitive information comes after I finish the ritual. What were you drinking out there?
Oh, I didn't know why you were doing that. I've already cast a prestidigitation across the room so no one can hear.
What she's doing is casting silence.
Okay.
Does prestidigitation do that?
Kind of all-purpose, anything you want to do out of combat magic's thing.
But I don't think it has the ability.
Has the ability to do that.
I could create a harmless sensory effect that blocks sound, I suppose. I'll let you do your thing. Go ahead. Yeah.
Okay.
About myself.
Yeah. She asked what you were drinking out in the bar.
Oh, it's just enjoying some ale from my hometown. They don't have quite the right size mug that it's usually served in, but it's good enough.
It'll do.
As you see, she's sort of focusing on this ritual right now, but you could tell she's sort of listening intently.
He's going to start taking off his boots and pants, be like, so this is what's going to happen next?
This is how it goes. I leave my money on the table, or...
Do I just sprinkle it on your face? Oh, I'm a terrible human being.
Well, we'll just say then that...
Yeah, small talk is not my strong suit, unfortunately, nor am I really in the mood for it at the moment.
I'll just say then that the time needed to cast the ritual passes, in which case she takes a seat across from on the table. So, if the palace is involved, this must be very significant.
Extremely so. Are you aware of the legends of the Dalhai?
I am. She's going to perk an eyebrow.
Things are unfolding. Yay! No.
I'm aware
how they once tried to invade our world. They once tried to invade our world and were sealed away.
Yes, and there's always a particular note of the word were.
Yes, they seem to have found another way back.
And your source for this?
Oh, I've fought them myself. I've seen them. All of Stormguard has seen them.
You've seen them?
Oh, yes. Far closer than I would ever have wanted to. And I'll do my little prestidigitation illusions of them.
Now, Chris, you would recognize some of them from your own research.
X is just going to kind of stare down at them and sort of take all the information in, which she's very sort of, it almost feels like the breath's been pulled out of her.
Mm-hmm.
Why would they send you to me then?
They seem to believe you could point me towards some worthy mercenaries or adventurers.
That and, just a side note, the Undercity works with the palace, so them, the Undercity knowing is kind of like arming them too, but they don't do that themselves. The palace wouldn't be part of that connection, so you're kind of like the messenger to tell them to, you know, arm themselves, keep a lookout, shit's going down. But your main mission is to inform Slade. As far as that goes. Sorry. Continue.
Yes, the palace also mentioned someone else.
Thorin. Thoril. Thoril.
Yes, Thoril.
Thoril. That's right, Tyler, right? Tyler fell asleep.
Thoril Firepeak.
Thoril. Yep.
Thoril, do you know this individual?
I do, though I don't know why they'd have you go to contact him.
Oh, I've only just arrived in the city. I do not know anyone here myself.
Well, they did tell you that he has been able to find extraordinary children or people, gifted people.
Well, I suppose you can explore that avenue yourself and see if anything comes up. I will get into contact with some people regarding mercenaries or any resources from the Undercity.
It's greatly appreciated. Not sure where I'll be staying at the moment. Could you recommend? Is this a good inn to stay in?
It's the best.
Actually, it is.
She has a very confident smirk when she says that too.
Well, then I shall get a room here.
If you ask Tarek, say it'll be a favor for me if he'll let you stay here, and I imagine he'll comp the service for today.
Most kind of you.
No. Thank you for this information.
Evil smile.
Inside check, no.
I'll meet up with you tomorrow, and I'll tell you anything that I may hear. Take it easy. I imagine the things you've seen are not easily forgotten.
Indeed not. I do not know if I will ever take it easy again, but...
Oh, don't say that.
For the moment, I will go and speak to this Thoril individual. Do I have directions to him, or should I ask her for them?
You, if she gave you directions to find her, she would have given you directions to find him.
Okay.
But he might... Just like how she might not be there, he might not be there, so he might ask for other directions just in case, but that's about it.
Yeah, she'll give you directions to him if you ask.
Yeah, I will. Yeah.
As she gets up to leave, she says, "Don't put too much pressure on your mind. It's a wonder what good ale and good company can do for yourself."
Or... I love your character, Chris. I seriously do.
And she's going to leave.
Okay. Chris, if you don't mind, I'm going to follow Dan through Thorl and then pick you up.
Oh, absolutely. Go for it.
Okay.
Get Tyler involved, man.
That's what I'm trying to get to. That's what I'm seriously trying to get to.
Been like, I'm in here. I rush home. Almost get hit by like four cars.
It's fucking raining.
They don't even
outside.
Need me for like 2 hours.
I'm sorry, Tyler. I've been trying to move it along to get you in there, but I got shuffled in with something. We're getting to you, man. We're getting to you. Don't worry.
Best for last. Whatever.
No, because we still got Waylon to do and more Chris.
All right. Well, I'll ask the bartender for a room, and I'll mention Alexis's name again.
Yep. Yeah. He obviously he's good natured with her. Pretty much your stay is on the house.
Sweet. I will follow my directions to Thorold's place then.
Okay, you enter the you pretty much it takes a good from where she is versus where he is. A good 15-20 minutes to even make, 15 minutes to make your way through the crowded streets. Well, they're starting to lighten up since the hour's going down, going up, down, whatever. And you do find it. It's probably about, I'd say, 9 p.m. by the time you make it to the slums and after the conversation you had. Or not 9 p.m., 8:30.
Okay, and what kind of building is it?
It's a, I think he lives in a, he's a hut dweller, right? Tyler?
Well, he's actually got some sort of physical home, unlike not a tent or shanty.
Okay, so, yeah.
Since he's got
there's a door I can knock on. Okay.
Yeah, flap the curtain.
I knock on the tent. Wait, what?
Yeah, you knock on the door. And a few moments later. Big, burly Goliath man opens the door. And he literally just stands there waiting for you to say something.
Good evening, sir. I'm looking for Thorl.
You found him.
Excellent. My name is Geddon. Some associates of mine at the palace gave me your name and said you may be able to help me.
It depends on what you're looking for, kid.
Perhaps we could speak somewhere more private.
He rolls an insight check on you? No. He opens his door and all the way and allows you inside. Tyler, does he have kids stay with him?
Well, yeah, it's okay. Safer for them.
I wasn't exactly sure how you planned him out because we didn't go into much backstory or how he handles his things. Okay. It's a it looks larger on the inside than it does on the outside. A lot of rooms. There's a lot of toys on the floor, actually. The house seems to be kept, but a little bit unorganized because of the, it looks like he has a lot of children.
Mm-hmm.
And, he makes his way through, he guides you back into the dining room and, pulls out a chair for you and throws down a mug, fills it with some booze and, sits down with you and says, so what do you got for me, boy?
Oh, I'll take a polite sip. And
it's good shit. Endurance check to stay awake. No. Go ahead.
I'm putting together a group of adventurers for an important mission on behalf of the city to scout out a threat that may be approaching from the north.
Tyler, do you live with them?
Yeah.
Okay. Sorry, go on.
Yeah, the queen seemed to think that you would know some brave souls who would be interested in this sort of work.
He looks at you and he goes, "Well, right now, the kids I'm housing are far too young for your type of mission that you're looking for, but I might have one." And he gives a sharp whistle, and Tyler, you're upstairs. Which obviously, this is how he's basically calling you. He just says, "You hear a sharp whistle, and you hear him yell out, 'Hey, boy, come down here.'"
I quickly comply and walk down.
What are you? Are you wearing your normal wear, or are you wearing your
just normal clothes? Okay. Probably.
He looks at you, and he looks at Dan, and he goes, Dan's character is Gideon. Geddon. He looks at Geddon, and he's like, he's relatively new at what he does, but he's shown a lot of promise lately. He's starting to get much better, and I think he's the right man for what you might be doing.
Oh, you need all the good men I can get. If he shows promise, all the better. I'll be the first soldier I've had to train.
Well, he's trained with me for many years.
I don't take training from anybody but Master Thoril.
That was unexpected. Go on. I wasn't expecting the voice yet. Okay, I'm sorry.
Indeed. Well, if you take my coin and fight for the city under my leadership, you'll take my orders.
For the city.
Yes, there is a grave threat to the city.
Thorold noticeably stands up and puts his hand on your shoulder, Tyler, and says, "Sometimes, boy, you gotta swallow your pride and just do what people need of you."
For the family.
He squeezes your shoulder and says, "For the family."
Of course.
Yes, if you come with me, lad, we'll protect your family and perhaps avenge mine.
Tyler, what's your fucking name? Malik. Sorry. He gives Malik a large slap on the back and says, "Just do what the man says. I guarantee you'll be a fuck. What was it? Scratch that. He just slaps you on the back." I lost it. I had something that wasn't on my notes.
It looks like you want to say something, Master.
I'll let it. I just don't know, sir. But he's like, I don't know if I'm quite ready to throw you out. I want to just make sure that you know what you're doing. And he's like, one more spar before you go.
Of course.
All right, to the map. Not visible to players. Somebody make that visible.
Let's see, that is the slums.
Correct.
They're visible. All right.
Slums map, drop tokens. Can I put the villager or the town folks on the initiative list?
So they can run away?
Run away.
Tyler, are you dropping yours too?
I'm getting there.
Okay. Yep. All right. So we couldn't find any good huts or anything like that. So this is what we're going to have to do. I got a question mark for Dan's character. I don't know about you guys.
No, I've got a picture.
He's It'll show up in a second. It's just loading.
Okay. Select all, add initiative.
Question marks are better than X's anyway.
Where is add to initiative? There you are. Thank you. All right. He's going to start up here. Aww.
And Malik, you are within 5 squares of me, so you get a +2 to your initiative from me.
Okay. Where's initiative on my token?
It's with mine. It's near health.
Oh, you don't have one? I thought I gave you one. I mean, copied mine.
All right. What's my plus to it? Dan, what are you granting me?
+2.
+2 for being near me.
Okay. I'm technically an ally too. Do I get +2?
You're not an ally. I don't give you initiative.
I hate you. shit. Give me 1 second. I completely forgot something. Boop. Boop. What does the puppy see? All right, I'm good. Balak.
All right.
You may go.
Woofs. Charge villain's menace.
Mm-hmm. Hit.
All your powers are macro, sir, if you just want to use those.
Yeah, I was. It won't let me.
Let me give you ownership of your token. Tyler. Okay, try now.
Oh, that wasn't that was an attack. That was this fucking...
Yeah, that was my niche.
Yeah, my bad.
There you go.
Oh, there we go.
That is a hit.
Oh.
13.
Okay.
13 damage.
And I'll throw Furious Assault on top of it.
Ooh, yay. Another one damage.
Damn it. And to end my turn, I will use Glowering Threat. You take a minus 5 penalty to attack rolls against any creature other than me.
Okay.
Oh, no, wait, that was a charge. I don't get to do that. Never mind.
Well, you could have just walked up and done that. You had, all your actions.
Get in.
Okay. Minor action, Promise of Storm. My lightning and thunder attacks now do an extra D8 of damage. And so I will arc lightning him.
Oh, okay. This is going to hurt.
22 versus his reflex.
Yep.
And Promise of Storm does an extra 8, so that is 23 damage.
Oh, shoot. I'm still at the bottom. Doesn't matter. 20, how much?
23. So another 6.
Anything from you, sir?
I've got a move left, but nah, that's fine.
All right. Well, since Tyler, you're the first person, you're the person in front of him.
Grr.
He's going to use push through.
Yeah.
Boop. And you are prone. And I shift into your vacant square. And that shall be all for him.
Okay.
He's going to look down at you and say, "You got to do better than that, boy."
Stand up. And then I will minor Rain of Steel.
Yay, one damage.
Oh, no, I guess. Oh, that's
it's when they start their turn, they take damage from it. Just say you're in the stance now, yeah.
Okay.
Ah, never mind. Yeah, I just do one weapon damage, so that's the roll for it. I didn't realize. Okay.
Okay. So every turn I start next to you, I take one damage.
No.
I roll a weapon.
Okay.
Damage. The way he's rolling, yeah, you take one damage.
Okay, so I take one damage right now.
No.
No. Thank you. Go ahead.
Okay.
I'm sorry. I got confused.
I did too.
Your confusion has confused me.
Mm-hmm. So I will use Serpent's Coil.
Yes. Hit. And I am grabbed.
And that will be the end of my turn.
12 damage and grabbed. Okay. I should have used the other one. Dan?
And four, plus 4 damage for your villainous thing as well.
Oh, yeah. So.
Four more damage.
Mm-hmm.
There we go.
Okay, I will move. Can't quite get into flanking. I will move there, and I will use Commander's Strike. So, Malak, make a melee basic attack with plus 4 bonus to damage.
I know what I'm doing. I don't need your help.
So, just do it.
Somebody might have wasted a standard. No. I'm sorry. Go ahead. As you were doing. You actually not taking the standard or the attack?
No.
No? Okay.
Alrighty then.
Anything else from you getting?
Nope.
Nah? Alright. I'm gonna hit you with my club. Well, Malak, because I'm still under the -4 or -5. Aww. And to escape the grab. Can I even escape it?
Yeah, it's a move action. Athletics versus his fortitude, or acrobatics versus his reflex.
Athletics.
Athletics, was it?
Against
equals it, so yeah, he gets it.
Okay, yep. And I shift one. There. His turn is finished. Malak, you may go.
All right.
Should open up.
Oh, did he take his one damage for starting his turn next to Malak?
Well. 8. Ha!
Poo.
Next time, yes.
Poo!
All right. I will use, let's use footwork lure here.
Mm-hmm. Miss.
And, I will, there's nowhere really to shift, so instead I'll just kind of slide. I have to slide you in the spot I go to, right?
Yeah.
No, it's you knock him prone instead, and you don't have to shift if you don't want to.
I can choose to knock him prone.
You can knock him prone or slide him one square.
Yes.
It's your option, yeah.
But you missed.
Oh, I didn't even see.
Yeah, yes. You missed. By 3.
You do have a +2 to that, but I don't think it's enough.
No. He's got a 7, I got an 18.
Okay.
Get in.
Okay.
Hit me with your best shot.
Alright, minor action. Calculated acumen. One creature within 10 squares of you. You learn the vulnerabilities of that creature, and it grants combat advantage to you until the end of your turn. Does he have any vulnerabilities?
I don't think we gave him any. No, he doesn't.
But I have combat advantage against him.
Correct.
I'm going to arc lightning him again.
Okay.
So, 21 versus his reflex.
21 is a hit.
He takes 12 lightning damage.
Ow. Boop.
And I'm done.
Alright.
He takes his 8 damage then. He's starting his turn.
Yes! You and your fucking chip damage. He is going to Great Club Malak again. Fucking shit! I want to hit you.
Well,
you have an action point.
I know. I'm saving that for when he's bloodied.
All right.
he's going to use Stone's Endurance. I'm going to gain Resist 5 to all damage until the end of my next turn. Which is that. And his turn is finished. And I'm not shifting over because I don't want to give you flanking, Dan.
I noticed.
I'm going to block you fuckers off.
Alright. Does that hit? 22 versus AC.
Hits.
Okay, so 14 damage. And I can shift one and slide you one.
Damn you.
Then
shift there if you can. That's easier for me to get flanking. But you're not listening to me anyway, so whatever.
Yeah.
Ten damage.
Then I will use my action point.
Okay.
And use footwork lure again. 20 versus AC.
Hit.
11 damage, and you are now knocked prone.
Oh, you sly boots.
And that will be the end of my turn.
Oh, he has just become bloodied. Immediate interrupt. From the attack that you just did to bloody me. Apparently.
Interrupt?
Immediate interrupt is what's saying. Doesn't matter. Fuck you.
You made me too strong.
No, boy. You have yet to learn everything. And that is my turn now, right?
That was your immediate, so... my turn.
Oh, yeah, yeah. It was Malik. I need to start really using that thing, the next round thing, so I can stop looking at it. I'm sorry.
I'm going to move there. Common advantage, yay. And I will hit him with my sword. 23 versus AC.
Hit.
14 damage.
Ouch.
And that'll do it for me.
Alright, Mr. Goliath is going to stand the fuck back up. He's slow to get up, you know, he uses his great club to, where the fuck is my movement thing? Fuck it, I'm not gonna move it. He uses his great club to stand up, and, smiles at you, Malik. And, because he's bloody, he recharges his, push through. And that's what I'll be using again. 20 versus fort.
Interrupt shield edge block.
Okay. Miss.
Doesn't matter. Still minus 4 penalty.
Common advantage and plus 2. That might actually hit.
What is it?
Six. It's actually 18 versus AC.
18 is a hit.
Okay.
12 so, damage.
I think he still has his 5 resist all, though. So he would have actually taken 5 less from my hit as well.
5 less from yours and 5 less from this one, 10. So he's going to do 4 damage to him, basically, from this attack. Or not 4. 2. I'm sorry.
Yeah.
-4 to the attack roll I made.
So 16 versus fortitude.
2?
It's 16. He has to resist 5 still, so it's counting up a couple. Well,
it's not 16. Oh, yeah, 16. I'm sorry.
Yeah, 16 to fortitude. Miss?
Yeah, that's a miss.
Okay. He is going to... Where is... State? Move. Prone. Move. Okay. He is finished. Because I can't shift. Malik, what do you got for me?
Footwork lure again.
Yeah, I could bust out a daily on him?
I did already.
Oh, you did?
Oh yeah, Rain of Steel from earlier.
Oh, shit, I had an action point. Motherfucker!
Yeah, I don't think it would have helped.
No.
So, 3 damage for the Rain of Steel. 11 damage for the... But look, lure.
And my resist 5 is gone.
And now you're prone.
Oh, goody. Prone. Gidden, what do you got?
See if we can finish this. Stand the Fallen. 22 versus AC.
Hit.
18 damage. And you can spend his healing surge, Malik.
No need.
Mm. My turn. I'm going to get the fuck back up. I didn't get to use my charge. You're lucky. He's going to get back up, and he's going to hit Malik again with his great club.
Miss.
Powerful warning. Busted your defenses, which you don't need, and you can make a melee basic attack against him as a free action.
I told you I know how to fight.
Obviously not, or he would be down now. Take the help.
He's,
an outsider like you, no.
You're, Thorl is gonna, you know, just look at you and go, listen to the man. He's seen battle, he's seen wars. I can see it in his eyes.
For you, master.
That's a hit. 12 damage. He's down. He's gonna hit, fall to his ass on the floor, kind of prop himself, rest his club in his lap, and just be like, "You're good, kid, but you still have a lot to learn. You want to be a warrior, a defender of people, correct?"
"Of course, like you."
You've learned everything I can possibly teach to. There's just other people who can teach you more, and this man is one of them. You may not like him now, but you really need to give him the chance to show his worthiness to you."
Malik looks at Geddon very cautiously.
"You're strong, kid. You move well. You need to learn to work as a team. No matter how strong you are on the battlefield, one man cannot accomplish nearly as much as a team can working together."
Thorl steps up and puts his arm over Malik's shoulder and gives him, you know, kind of like shakes him up a little bit, and he goes, this one's a stubborn one. Might take a little while for him to understand, but I have faith his eyes will open soon." He's gonna turn to you, look at Malik in the eyes, and go, "Trust me, kid."
"If you say so, master."
"Now be off with you. Don't go getting yourself killed and all. Don't have to hide that from the children."
"Of course."
"Stop calling me master. It creeps me out."
"Don't call me master either. That's weird."
"I won't."
Duel. No.
"Sure, I just love a daily left."
I still have Reign of Steel's dance going.
With that, you know, he leads back into towards his house and says to you, he looks at Geddon and he's like, "The kid's in your hands now. Keep a good eye out on him. Keep him away from the ladies, though. He wants to buy every one of them for some reason."
"Huh. All
right. You only have a fascination for the ladies of the night, right? Not like a really, like a wine drinker, a drunkard."
"I wouldn't say I'm fascinated with ladies. No. That's all he knows.
He's talking it up because it's something that you do that you do on a somewhat regular basis, I would assume.
Yeah.
just keep the kid away from the ladies."
He drinks, but he handles his drink.
Yeah. He likes the ladies a lot.
I come down the stairs and I've got my miner's hat and my ever burning torch stuck in it, as it's clearly getting night out.
Yeah. He's he's going to pull Geddon aside and be like, "Just between you and I, the kid's afraid of the dark. Try and be a little easy on him. when it comes to this kind of thing. A lot of bad things happen to him when it comes to the night.
Well, a lot of bad things are about to happen to all of us if he doesn't grow up. I'll do what I can.
He opens the door. He lets you guys both out, and basically, you know, like you're standing on both sides of him. He's behind you, and he slaps you both extremely hard on the back to basically kind of push you out and let you off into the world, basically. And he laughs, and he looks at you and he says, "Be careful out there. There's a lot of things out there that a boy of your age shouldn't be seeing right now."
I have to see him eventually.
Just remember, not everything in this world is evil. And listen to the man. He's a good kid. Gesturing towards Gideon. And you two can do whatever the fuck you want now. He's gonna go inside, you know. Actually, he goes inside and retrieves a pouch and throws it at Malik. Use it wisely, kid. It's a small sack of coins.
I nod and tuck it away.
Okay. Roughly about 100 gold.
Okay.
I'm just giving money away today.
Yay, free monies.
Okay. I'm guessing Tyler or Dan, you're going to just basically take him back to the inn.
Actually, I have something I'd like to do. Sure. I'm going to wait until we are passing through a dark alley, though.
Oh, you're going to teach the kid not to be afraid of the dark already?
Not entirely.
Oh, shit. Yeah, sure, you find a dark alley.
Alright, as we were passing through a dark alley and there are no other light sources nearby...
Other than the one he has.
I'm going to use prestidigitation to instantly light or snuff out a candle, torch, or small campfire.
It's a magical it's a magical fire.
It's ever burning torch.
It won't be put out.
It's a torch.
It's not a torch of the traditional sense.
It has no heat.
Yeah.
It's only light.
Yeah. It's a light bulb.
Can I use magic to snuff out a magic item? It's only temporary, but still.
You know what? I'm a person of a.
Yeah, I'll play with it.
Yeah, let's do it. You can do it. I'm just trying to think if you would be able to do it on sun rods, and I don't think you should be able to, but yeah, let's do it with the torches. Yes, you are able to put out the torch with your magical MacGuffin. That's what that fucking spell is.
Being a wizard, yes.
Fuck you, Dan.
Malik just immediately looks up, takes the torch off his helmet, and starts like
beating it on the ground,
poking it and like hitting it against the wall. He's freaking out, starting to sweat very badly, and immediately starts walking very quickly out of the alley as soon as wherever the exit to it is.
All right, I'll just put my hand on his shoulder and say, "Hold up, lad, it's all right."
I immediately push you away and just walk right past you.
You're making me make a strength check, aren't you?
Yeah, roll a strength check to keep a hold on him.
That's a five, so... fail.
Not even close.
He bull rushes right through you. Looks like your attempt failed, Dan.
Apparently.
Within a few minutes,
It seems, it seems he gets I'll just follow him out of the alley, and yeah. I'll remove my effect so it lights up again.
Yeah, I was going to say it would have worn off by now, but yeah. It goes off, or it comes back on. I need an endurance check to keep you from Malik from peeing yourself. No, I'm kidding.
It's all right to be afraid, lad. Every man has fear. You don't have to face it alone.
I put my hand tightly on your shoulder.
Ow.
The dark. I hate the dark. It's not okay.
You have comrades beside you. We need fear nothing. I'm gonna put my hand on his shield and use everything. My light cantrip on his shield. So his shield is now brightly sheds light in two squares.
You have a huge nightlight now, Tyler. That should make
twice, you have twice the light now.
You should be humping his leg right now.
Oh, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. Om nom 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 nom.
I can make light or I can take it away.
Don't piss me off, boy.
No.
Don't take it away. Bad things happen.
I don't want to take it away. I want you to follow my orders. I want you to be victorious in combat. I want you to always have light in the darkness.
Sounds like a gay romance is starting on between you guys.
Oh, fuck no. I have a girlfriend who's probably dead. Now I'm sad again.
So, where are you guys headed to now?
Back to the inn. I'll get him a room there as well.
Okay. Now, that room's not on the house.
I'll pay for it. Under my command now.
Okay.
How much is it?
Let's say that place, standard room.
Mm-hmm.
1 gold.
Okay.
I'm assuming you guys are going to bed.
Actually, I want to talk to him first.
Oh, sure. I'm sorry.
Okay.
So, what the hell's this? What's going on? What is the job?
Alright, once you're back in the inn, in a private room,
Imagine McGuffin.
Have you heard of the Dalhai?
That would be a no.
He gives you a very blank stare.
ancient monsters from another world.
He continues
they tried,
to
they tried to invade our world long ago.
So?
They were sealed away in their own world, but now they've returned. Their armies are vast. They destroyed my city. I came here to warn this city. Now I'm leading a small band. Wish you are the first to north to scout what they are doing.
Where are you from?
I am from Stormguard.
The Rock of the North.
I've heard of there. One of my brothers went there.
Oh, what was his name?
Yenfire.
Yenfire? I knew him. He attended the Rockland Academy with me.
Yeah, you pronounced that one right.
It's not that hard.
Is he all right?
No one from Stormguard is all right. He is most likely lost in the fighting.
What time did they attack?
I'm really going there? Okay. I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry.
About a month ago. The
what
city finally
time?
Fell.
He means time of
day.
What time of day? It was. I assume it was during the day. I don't know.
It lasted for weeks.
We were fighting for a month. It was like when the final attack on the city came. I think it was during the day.
Yeah, it happened. Like they first started invading during dawn, and it lasted for roughly a month.
Malik lets out a very deep sigh. Then maybe he is all right.
I hope so. I hope some of my friends and family actually survived. But it is a faint hope at the moment.
So if your whole city fell, how are we supposed to stop them?
For the moment, we are only scouts. Our mission is to observe the enemy. so that the city will be prepared for their attack. Your city may fare better than mine.
All right.
It really is for the family.
Would you like to see what our enemy looks like?
Did they die?
Oh, they can be killed.
Then it matters not.
Like your attitude, but you'd still be prepared. Your particular fear may play into their hands otherwise. For their foot soldiers are beings made of shadow.
He gives you a very wide-eyed look.
Night terrors. And this is where I open my next beer.
Malik actually starts to grab his flask and starts to undo it a little bit. Takes a small sip.
All right.
Your little torch and mining helm may come in handy. They don't like the light. Keep them away from you.
What does these shadows look like?
I'll do my little prestidigitation trick for a hand's high size shadow guy.
Okay. You want a description, Tyler?
Okay.
Human size. Human male. Or not human. Yeah, human males type size. They seem to be completely manifested from smoke, or they don't look solid to you. They look like a shadow on a wall. They have long, long-type claws on each hand. They're relatively skinny. They have no visible mouths or anything, or nose, or any kind of face features other than glowing red eyes. You do not get a particularly nice feeling from what these things look like.
Malik tastes... A little longer sip from his flask.
Yes, right. These are just the foot soldiers. They have worse. I won't burden you with those tonight, though.
Very well. I'm sure I will have more to ask of you later. For now, I need to calm down. And it just...
Yes, it's been an exceedingly long day for me as well. I will see you in the morning, lad.
Very well.
And scene. All right. Tyler and Dan, you guys are pretty much free for a little while. The next part will take care of the other three. Jason, Waylon, Scott... and Chris. Chris, are you ready?
Yeah, what's up?
Alright, we are taken into your scene now. After that, we're going into Waylon. Chris, you have arrived to the Undercity, I'm assuming, to deliver your message.
Yes. Well, I was also there to have dinner with them.
Yes.
But yeah. Obviously, I come with much more pressing news.
As far as time goes, it's roughly around, it's a little after 8, you know, because I got to backtrack time for this.
Yeah.
It's a little after 8. It's dark out. So, you may proceed, sir.
She's going to head on in towards, well, actually, how does he get food down there, or does Alexis normally bring food with her?
It's either or. I mean, it's whatever you feel like you want to do. If you want to order in, basically, it can be done, or if you want to bring your own little special type of food. You can.
I'll say that she brings something along.
Okay. Just remember, he's not a vegetarian.
I know.
Okay.
So, for some reason, fucking meat monsters. Now she's going to knock on the door.
He can tell by your knock that it is you, and basically just answers it and says, "Well, come on in."
Thank you. It has been a very interesting day. How about yours, hon?
Actually, my day has been pretty lazy. I mean, other than the business with you and a couple of merchants having a problem with our fences having problems with our rates. It's been a rather quiet day.
What would be a meal he particularly likes?
Venison, elk.
I got this for you. I know it's one of your favorites.
When you came in, he was actually kind of sitting back in his chair with his boots up on the corner of the table. And when you show that, he kind of perks up a little bit. he brings his feet down and kind of scoots into the desk and says, "And what will you be dining with?"
Just some small salad. Not really in a great appetite anymore.
You and salads. I don't see what you see in those things.
Well, it's a long story. Look, I've got a few things on my mind right now. Found out some interesting information I figured you'd want to know, so I don't know if you want.
Have you sat yet?
Yes.
Okay, I'm sorry.
Sorry, I shouldn't have that.
It's all right. Please continue.
I found out some news you might find particularly pressing.
He kind of leans in, you know, putting his you know, clasping his hands together, putting his chin on his fist.
After my performance, I was about to leave when I was stopped by a Genasi, who apparently comes from Stormguard.
Ah, yes, Stormguard. Nice city.
Was a nice city, from what I understand.
He kind of tilts his head to the side.
I had a private meeting with him because he mentioned that the palace wanted to speak with me. Apparently, and I can't quite believe this myself, but the Delrai are back.
Delhi. Yes.
The Delhi are back.
He sits deep back in his chair and brings a finger up to his forehead and just kind of rubs the side of his temple. The Delhi.
That was my reaction too, but this gentleman saw them himself. Didn't seem like he was lying, and if the palace sent him, then they must believe it too.
Well, I believe it too. In fact, I know they're even here.
The Delhi?
Yes. Remember what, this is harking back to the conversation we had.
Yeah.
You remember the conversation we had a few weeks ago?
Yes. Yes.
I have,
Just be careful, though.
I have managed to find some, even in our fair area, speaking of the Undercity.
In the Undercity.
He nods. He puts the knife and fork, you know, on top of his meal. A nice cross between the knife and fork. And stands up, walks over to his to a countertop and pulls his blades. And puts them around his waist and picks up his mask and throws it on. And says, "Come with me."
Are you preparing to fight?
No, I'm preparing to show you something.
She's going to get up, but she's going to be a bit confused. I imagine he doesn't generally arm himself around her.
No. This is probably like one of the handful of times that you've actually seen him arm himself. And he's going to get up and walk over to the... To the front door. Hold on a second. I'm having problems.
You would have problems.
No, shut up, Chris. the stream's coming down for...
View of anything.
Nope. All the candles are snuffed. It doesn't look like anybody is in the house. If you're staying quiet, you know, listening for anybody, you don't hear anybody either.
Okay. Uh-huh.
You're just like, I hope he's not married. I hope he's not married.
Yeah. I'm sure she would be easy to kill. Anyways.
You go into the main hallway, basically. Right, you're going inside?
Yeah, go inside, and if I get near any windows, essentially just pull the blinds so they haven't been already, so no one can see in.
Okay, you do that. There are a couple, if you're looking for things to possibly lift...
Yep, shiny things.
You do find some shiny things, just on the first floor. A couple of golden, what look to be golden plates, candle holders, some silken table mats. High quality silk table mats. And the rest you really can't take out. There's a grandfather clock, a piano.
Yeah. Small things.
Yes. Some dishware, or you take some silverware. If you would like. Some silvers.
Alright. There's a second story to the house.
Yes, there is.
Essentially, put the stuff that I grabbed by the door.
Back downstairs.
Yeah, downstairs.
Okay.
And sneak my way up to the second story.
All right, the steps creak as you go up, but nothing outside of that. Upstairs is a hallway with two doors or three doors. You know, one to your left, one to your right, and one in front of you.
Actually, how far am I away from my fence right now?
About 200 yards from where the opening is to get to where you're at. And there's no way you can get to it without going through the main street. You have to cross the street. Unless you go in through the back way, which is going through the Undercity, which will require streetwise. And maybe Dungeoneering. Just because I want to use Dungeoneering as an actual skill. So,
how much time do I have left before, I would think?
Minutes.
Do I know a back way to my house?
Yes, but you're still going to have to cross the street to get to it.
Cross the street. Evident pillowcase.
You look very shady at this moment, by the way.
It looks odd, yeah. How would I do
You're
this?
A drow Santa now. And a monk comes walking up behind you again. How are you doing? No.
You see my master yet?
I'm going to essentially try and find go through the back ways, try and find the smallest crossing I can get for the main road. Get as far away from the biggest crowd I can.
Okay, you're gonna be taking a longer route.
Yeah, I know.
So, I'm gonna have to make a check or make a roll. Sure. Give me two stealth checks, and that'll be it. Or two stealth checks and one acrobatics check.
Dump, dump, and dump. Ah, acrobatics. Fuck.
You're good. Now,
I'm actually going to take. I'm sure the pillows have covers on them, right?
Correct.
I'm gonna just take a cover pillow and start pretty much putting what I got in there.
Okay.
And we'll head into the other room if there's nothing else in there.
All right. This room is.
I'll check under the mattress and under the bed too.
Nothing there.
All right.
You go off to the last room?
Yep.
It is locked.
Oh. Always good things in locked doors. 20 to unlock.
You make it.
Slowly open. Look around.
It is a large, empty room with a telescope pointing out a window. With one chair.
Where is this telescope pointing to?
Are you going up to it and looking?
Pretty much.
Okay. You look through the telescope and it points into another person's bedroom across the hall.
Oh, this guy's a creep. And I'll actually take the telescope.
You're an evil man. Or woman.
Yes.
And the floor is lit, littered with tissue paper.
I gingerly step around.
Okay. I'm going to need a ginger check.
I suppose the closest thing. I got stealth. There. I avoid it like the plague.
All right, you easily take all this shit. Basically, you're going your way back out the same way you came in.
Mm-hmm.
All right. You open up the cellar door and close it behind you. Mm-hmm. And now the hard part is, how are you going to get from where you are back to home?
All right.
Yeah.
I'll make sure no one's around, which I'm sure is a perception check.
Yep.
Don't
you don't notice anybody. You don't notice anybody.
And we'll attempt to open the storm cellar and enter the house.
And thievery check. It is locked.
No. No, I get tools with that.
Yep.
Right. 21.
You open it easily.
Okay.
And I'm going to make sure... do you just go through? 'Cause,
I go through and close the door behind me.
I'm assuming you're doing it stealthily, too, so you don't make a ruckus making the noise. Okay. I'm not going to make you roll for it. I'm assuming you know how to close the door. silently, at least. All right. The cellar is rather dark, which is not a problem for you. It is basically just a storage cellar for... there's some wine down there. Wine barrels... Or not wine... wine barrels, beer barrels. And... random boxes and fixings for whatever. If you want to give me a perception check really quick.
Oh, I was about to say, looking through the wine, do I see any high quality shit?
You do find some that might seem high quality to you. I would say 3.
I'll grab the 3 and put them to the, next to the door to the,
Okay. Storm cellar.
The door cellar, yeah.
Yep.
Put it at, next to there and just continue along the way.
To the back of the room, you see a stairway going up.
Go up the stairway to a door, I'm guessing?
Correct.
Locked?
No.
Ooh, all right. Open it quietly, kind of stick my head around, make sure I'm not... Oh, start with the one on the right.
One on the right. You open it up, it's unlocked, you open it up... I'm guessing sneakily, quiet, look around before fully opening the door?
Yep.
Okay, rinse and repeat on all the doors?
Pretty much.
Okay. You see, this is a study. A desk with one window and a few bookshelves.
All right.
And one candle holder. if you're looking for anything of value here, give me a perception check on some things.
Yeah.
No. To you, it's just a bunch of paperwork.
Nothing in any of the drawers or...
Just inkwells, some feathers, spare note paper type things like that.
Mm. Go back, close the door, go across the hallway, so the one that would be on the left.
The one on the left, you open that one, that's his bedroom.
Okay.
And in that one, large rug, huge bed, silken covers, and you find there's a nightstand next to the bed along with two dressers. Assuming you're going through those items, you are finding a lot of silken clothing, and one dresser is just full of just garbage clothing. Just stuff that looks like his normal wear that he would wear, and other things were his formal wear.
Stuff that he's pissed in.
Yes. And inside his nightstand, you find a... let's see, what is it? Another sack of gold. Another little baggie of gold. And a few other miscellaneous pieces of jewelry.
Alright.